Firstly, we will pay homage to the Buddha, say Namo Tassa three times. Namo Tassa Bhagavato Arahato Sammasambuddhassa. Namo Tassa Bhagavato Arahato Sammasambuddhassa. Namo Tassa Bhagavato Arahato Sammasambuddhassa. Today, I would like to talk about how to practice meditation, or how to practice vipassana, how to practice satipatthana. Satipatthana, vipassana, they're namely different, but the same meaning. People usually do every day for their life, not really mindful, but they are present moment. So that's why I would like to talk about how to practice mindfulness at the every moment. So if you know the purpose of practice vipassana, the meditation vipassana is not difficult. That's why you have to know the purpose of the practice vipassana. Vipassana, dripadana means we just observe our own body and mind. Why we need to observe? Because every day you are doing something not really observing your body and mind. So that's why we just observe our nature of the body and mind. So what does nature of the body and mind mean? That naturally our bodies, because of the weather, because of the food, so our body changing, heat or cold, tight, heavy, peaceful, not peaceful. Sometimes the body light, heavy, pain, itchy, uncomfortable, comfortable. The mind, naturally the mind thinking a lot of things, mostly lobha, dosa, moha. So actually, when you practice meditation, we have to observe your kusala mind, akusala mind. Sometimes you have the kusala mind, you want to do the dhana, sila, bhavana. Sometimes you are angry, upset. Sometimes you have the greedy, the wandering mind, thinking mind a lot. So we just observe those kind of mind. But sometimes some people, they thought they want to be peaceful and calm. That's why when they see their body uncomfortable, pain, itchy, tired, heavy, so they don't like it. When they see a lot of akusala, lobha, dosa, moha, sleepy, wandering mind, they don't like it. Actually, meditation means that you observe those kind of body and mind, the nature of the body, heat or cold, tight, heavy, pain, itchy, uncomfortable, discomfort. The mind usually, kusala, akusala mind, you just observe sleepy. So if you know how to observe, write this, just observe, do not try to control or do not try to be upset. So then your meditation will be easier. But if you do not know how to observe, you don't like sleepy, wandering mind, angry mind, upset mind, so then you just get up. So you want to do something. Actually, when you would like to do meditation, you need to have the very strong determination. I will sit about 1 hour. Even though I feel pain, I feel discomfort. So I feel a lot of wandering mind. This is the meditation object. So when you have the determination, then observe every day, within a few days or within a few hours, you gain concentration mindfulness. So then you will be easier for practice mindfulness. So practice mindfulness, the Buddha teach firstly sitting meditation about 1 hour, then walking meditation about 1 hour, other daily mindfulness, eating, drinking the water, using the toilet, taking the shower every day. Because practice mindfulness is required every moment, not only sitting meditation, not only walking meditation. In the Mahadhyana Sutta, the Buddha explained very detailed how to observe the body, kaya nupassana, how to observe the vedana, the feeling, how to observe the mind, siddha nupassana, how to observe the general object, dhamma nupassana. So body means, so mainly we have the four elements. Atavi, avo, deso, vayo. You will see hot, cold, tight, heavy, or sometimes pain, itchy. The feelings, you have the good feeling, bad feeling in your mind and body. Sometimes you feel happy. Sometimes you feel not happy. Sometimes you feel angry, upset. Or sometimes you feel very good in the body and mind. Go off. So sukha vedana, dukkha vedana, sometimes neutral upekkha vedana, you just observe. There usually people have the kusala agusala mind, mostly agusala mind. Because buddhacana, ordinary people have mostly agusala mind. When you practice vipassana, you have to observe this agusala mind mostly. Sometimes you can observe the kusala mind, this is observing the mind. So observing the general object, seeing, hearing, smelling, tasting, touching, just observe. When you practice sitting meditation, you don't need to adjust your body a lot. Just the breathe normally, then observing the rising, falling. Don't need to worry about the body shaking or body is leaning or something. Of course, when you are uncomfortable, if you would like to change your position, you can change with the mindfulness. But during the 1 hour sitting meditation, do not open your eyes to check or something. Even when you would like to change your position, you have to change your position with the mindfulness without opening your eyes. So in this way, your mindfulness will be continuously, so then, so you will not lose your mindfulness. So that's why during the sitting 1 hour, so you have to close your eyes, straight your upper body, but do not worry too much about body. The sitting, my body is leaning, my body is shaking, so you have to observe the primary object, rising, falling. So rising, falling. So you have to observe primary object carefully, follow the rising, falling. Sometimes they just use the rising, falling, but they are focusing on the object is not enough to see it. That's why when you do vipassana, sometimes you can do with the leveling, rising, falling. Sometimes you can do without leveling. The more important is that you see the rising, falling movement. When you observe rising, falling, also rising, falling can be many different ways. It depends on the yogi practice. Someone who practices rising, falling very long, they can see many kind of movement. That's why, even though we call rising, falling, but for the yogi, you have to just observe the movement of the abdomen. Sometimes the movement can be slow, sometimes fast, small, big, heavy, sometimes move up and down, side by side, some more. But if you keep observing the rising falling, so the purpose of the observing the rising falling is to see the nature of the body. So when you see the nature of the body and the abdomen, not only the abdomen, you will see the whole body. So you have to observe. Not only that, when you practice observing the rising falling, then when you improve, you will see also nature of your mind. There are many kinds of mind. Seeing the body and mind, the more you practice, the more you see it. Because the Buddha say that every nama rupa rises and passes away very quickly. Do not see it, do not practice. So like a dodo viya, when you look at the river seems doesn't move. But when you look at kalosa, so the river is moving. In the same way, when you observe closely our own body and mind, so every moment, the mind also changing, no day mind. So their body, their rising, falling, changing. But in the beginning, you don't need to look for the change of the rising, falling, change of the mind. For you just need to observe. When you have enough concentration, mindfulness, then you see the rising, falling, then you will see even the rising, falling changing a lot. Not only that, the whole body, whatever you observe, changing, you see a lot. Not only the body's mind also changing. So in this way, when you see the body and mind changing, changing, so cannot control, so you see, so every moment the body and mind is changing anicca. Every moment that they are changing dukkha, cannot control anatta. So in this way, so you can remove or reduce so attachment, so the tanha, the mana, wrong view of this is it. So I own actually the Buddha's teachings only the five khandhas. So the five khandhas means the rupa, body, the mind, nama. So no one can control, no one can own. So when you really see every the body and mind changing every moment, then you can reduce, remove tanha, mana, ditthi for the attachment of the body and mind. So if you remove this kilesa, you will be much happier for practice vipassana. So that's why the purpose of practice vipassana, we just observe body and mind. Finally, you can see body and mind changing every moment. But in the beginning, you don't need to look and for. You don't need to expect to see, just observe. Just observe sitting, walking. So daily mindfulness, when you improve, then you will see, you will gain the benefits. So now I would like to show how to do sitting meditation. Before you sit, you stand like this. When you stand, so you have to observe the whole body, standing. Then you go to the cushion. You have to observe right step, left step. So then observe standing. So you have to observe sitting down. Usually, before you sit, we do the respect, bowing down to the Buddha three times. So when you hang up, also you have to observe when you touch the hand, you have to observe, then move your body down and you touch the floor, then get up slowly, mindfully, three times. After you bow down the Buddha, you have to cross sitting like this. So put the two hands, then straight your upper body like this. So then close your eyes. Right? So you have to observe everything, moving your hands, touching your hands. Even you, when you close your eyes, you have to observe. So then after you close your eyes, sit, breathe normally. When you breathe in, the abdomen means this is navel, this below the navel. So when you breathe in, the abdomen will rise, not rising. When you breathe out, the abdomen will fall, not falling. You don't need to follow from the nose to air here. You don't need it. Just observe here, breathe normally. Breathe normally. When you breathe in, the abdomen will rise, not rising. When you breathe out, the abdomen will fall, not falling. You don't need to focus here or you don't need to follow the air here. You just observe here. Rising, falling. So sometimes some people, they see the rising, falling very obviously. Some people, they see rising, falling not obvious. Move slowly. Do not try to do anything. Do not try to breathe. Do not try to be the stronger breathe or slower breathe. So even though you see the rising, falling small, just observe carefully. So some yogi, they would like to see rising, falling very clear movement. Very clear movement. Then if they see rising, falling only a little bit movement, they are not satisfied. They want to do something. So if you do something, do not observe continuously, you will be very tired. That's why meditation means you need to understand how to observe the object. So even though you see there some more movement or not clear movement, you have to keep observing the rising falling here. So even though we call rising falling, but may not be always rise and fall. According to your yogi's experience, some yogi, they are old yogi, they can see many kind of movement. Right? Many kind of movement, many kind of the rising falling. But some yogi in the beginning they just see rise and fall, rise and fall, rise and fall. So you just aware of rise and fall. There are the four foundations of mindfulness, kaya, vedana, saita, dhamma. But don't worry about how to observe the mind. Don't worry about how to observe the feeling. Don't worry about how to observe the general object. Because if you know how to observe the body rising, falling, you will, if you really improve, you will understand automatically how to observe your mind, how to observe your feeling, how to observe your others. That's why in the beginning, you have to keep observing the rising, falling carefully, rising, falling carefully. So when you improve, yes, sometimes you see your mind. What time you need to observe your mind? Sometimes when you are observing the rising, falling, your mind already thinking something. When you realize you are already thinking or wandering mind, so you are not on the object, rising, falling, then you can observe thinking, wandering, planning. When you observe the thinking, wandering, planning also, there are two options. Sometimes you can observe until you finish thinking mind, wandering mind. But when the thinking mind, wandering mind so long, even though you observe, they keep coming, then you can go back to the rising, falling. Rising, falling. If you make a lot of effort to observe rising, falling, so the thinking mind, wandering mind cannot come easily. So that's why, so sometimes when you see a lot of wandering mind, thinking mind, you need to make more effort to observe the rising, falling. This is the two options, right? very thick, then get mind, very quick, then get mind, very quick, then get mind, you don't need to observe the mind. When you realize the one day mind already stopped, so you can keep observing the rising falling. So the others, so their bodies, so they're hot, cold, tight, heavy, or sometimes very tight, or sometimes their body shaking. So you can observe, it is too obvious. But it is just hot, means if you can keep observing the rising falling, you can still can keep observing the rising falling. Don't worry about the others. But they're hot, heavy, tight, discomfort, pain, itchy, very, very strong. You cannot observe the rising falling, you can observe, move. Also, when you observe those feelings, there are two options. You can observe and you this feeling go away. Also, this is very long, you can go back to the rising falling. So when you practice meditation, there can be many experiences. Sometimes you cannot breathe. Your body very tight. The body is very tight. So don't worry or do not try to open your eyes. Just observe. That there are other things. You have to keep observing the rising falling here. But when your effort becomes weak, the movement, you can see many places. Sometimes you can see the movement very tight in the chest, near the chest, or sometimes you can see in the head, or sometimes go up and down. So because your observation becomes weak, that's why the movement becomes obvious other place. So in the Pali text, there are six kinds of air movement in the Pali text. So one air is that we call anabana, coming from the nose, anabana, anabana air. The other is we call the air move up, Uddhangama air. The air come down, Dogama air, come down. So the one air stay on the abdomen. So the other air stay in the other, the body organs inside. The other is air movement go to the many part of the body. So when you observe the air in the abdomen, you have to stay here. If you are focusing, become weak, so the air movement can be many, obvious in many places. Maybe some yogi, they see the air movement here, some yogi here, some yogi here, some yogi here, some yogi. So if you follow this kind of air movement, so no, you cannot gain the concentration, mindfulness. So the purpose of vipassana is we need to see the nature of the body and mind. We need to see the nature of the body and mind changing all the time. So then the sanyogi, when they come to retreat, their body shake, or their body leaning down, eye opens, or something, because they cannot observe the rising falling properly. That's why those kind of things very become obvious. Sometimes some people, they feel the upper part of the body very heavy, tight, discomfort. So means when you practice vipassana, when you observe the rising falling carefully, you can overcome many difficulties. Seeing, for example, seeing, hearing, smelling, tasting, touching. Seeing the Buddha image, seeing the beaver, forest, cloud, skeleton, or seeing the kala, or sometimes hearing someone calling the voice, someone smelling, sometimes tasting, touching. You can see, you can observe. Why this experience, seeing, hearing, keep coming? Because you cannot observe carefully. So that's why the seeing, hearing, smelling, this thing can keep coming. So believe, when you do vipassana, whatever you observe carefully, the object will not be left very long. If the object lasts very long, means that your observation is not very obvious, not very effective. But if you are afraid of the pain, if you are afraid of the heat or cold, tight, many things, then in vipassana take very long. If you know how to observe, within a few days, a few weeks, so you can gain the vipassana jnana. But if you do not know how to observe, you practice maybe 5 years, 10 years, 20 years, not much different. So vipassana means you need to know the key point. Because we are training the mind, body. So if you are afraid of the dying, or if you are afraid of the pain, or you often, you know, the worry when you see something, your meditation will not improve. That's why even that the body is very tight, cannot move, or cannot breathe, very heavy, or very hot, or sometimes very pain, itchy. Sometimes some yogi, they want to go to take medicine, they want to see doctor, or they want to see something, exercise. Actually, vipassana is the Buddha himself called Mahabhisaka, the Buddha himself, a big doctor. A big doctor means he can cure the physical mental disease. So if you really trust him and his teachings, so then you have the very strong determination. Just observe the nature of the body and mind. Do not try to change anything. Then your vipassana knowledge can be developed very quickly. You can understand the vipassana. So that's why the main thing is, if you can keep observing the rising falling, you can overcome many things. If you can keep the rising falling, observing the rising falling, you can improve your meditation. In the beginning, you have to observe the rising falling carefully. And when you improve, wandering mind, thinking mind, pain, itchy, discomfort, heat or cold, seeing, hearing, it is obvious, you can observe. Then it is disappear or sometimes stop, you can go back to rising falling. So when you do sitting meditation, you have to do at least about 1 hour. When you finished, you cannot open your eyes immediately. Even when you are hearing the clock, hearing, when you finish, even when you get up, you have to observe, getting up. So you have to observe every day. This is how to practice. Then I would like to show you how to do sitting meditation myself. You have to observe your body movement, right step, left step. Then observe standing, the whole body. Then when you are sitting down, you have to observe your body sitting down, your knees, muscles slowly going down. And you have to observe your hand movement. Everything you have to observe. When you bow down to the Buddha, you just bow down but the mindfulness do not need to be very slow. Sometimes if you do very slow, you are not really observe. You are just moving slowly. That's why the more important is when you hold on, you do the bowing down with the mindfulness, your body movement. After you bow down, you practice sitting meditation. When you would like to take out your glass, also you move your hands and observe. Even when you finish, when you move your hands, you have to observe. You have to observe your hand movement. Put like this, straight your upper body. Then close your eyes. Breathe normally. When you breathe in, the abdomen will rise. Observe rising. When you breathe out, the abdomen will fall, no falling. Like I explained to you before, just observe the rising, falling. When you hear in the clock, no hearing, hearing. So when you would like to open your eyes, no intention to open the eyes. Intention to open the eyes. Opening the eyes. When you move, you have to observe your hands moving. When you would like to wearing the glass, you have to observe your hands moving. Meditation means you have to observe your every action. When you move your hands, you have to observe. When you would like to, now get up. Intention to get up, intention to get up, then slowly to observe your body movement. Then standing, observe. After you finish the meditation, you will do walking meditation. Then you will move your walking path. Right step, left step. So we will do walking meditation. Walking meditation also about 1 hour. When you do walking meditation, you can put your hand like this in front of you, or you can put like this. So look at about 2 or 3 feet in front of you. So when you do walking meditation, 1 hour you have to divide in a 3 part. The first 20 minutes you do right step, left step. Second 20 minutes you do lifting, placing. Third 20 minutes you do lifting, moving for placing. So before you do walking, you have to observe your body, standing, the whole body. When you observe your body, you have to observe the whole body, standing. Do walking meditation also, actually, you are observing that your foot, like in your daily life. But here, you do a little bit slower than your daily life. When you do walking meditation, do not try to control. Just observe the nature of your body movement. A little bit slower than your daily life. thumb, right step. Just observe left step. When you can enter the organ bath, do not turn immediately. Note standing, standing for a few times. Standing, standing down, turning, turning. Observe standing, standing again. When you observe standing, standing, observe the whole body. Then observe right step, left step. When you can enter the organ bath, also do not turn immediately. Observe standing, standing. Turning, turning the whole body. Observe standing, standing. Then this, the second 20 minutes, you observe lifting, releasing. When you observe the lifting, you have to observe the foot lifting, release. When you lift, you don't need to look for anything, just observe. Lift, and release down. When you lift, you just observe the lifting the foot. Place down. When you have enough concentration, you will see lifting the breath down, you will see just observe. When you can enter the walking path, not standing, 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 standing. When you do walking meditation, please make sure after you put down the foot completely, then you can lift another foot. Then you lift. Place down, you have to completely finish this one, then you have to lift this another, lift, make sure, and you completely finish this one, you have to move this one. Every step, if you can observe mindfully, you can gain a lot of concentration mindfulness. But you don't need to look in for any other sensation. You just observe. Lifting, placing. Standing. Standing. So this time we do the walking meditation, 3 step, lifting, moving forward, placing. Lift, move forward. You observe your foot, drop, you touch the floor. This one is more slower. When you come under the walking bus, observe standing a few times. Standing. Standing. Lifting. Move forward. This is the walking meditation. I will show you how to do daily mindfulness. Walk mindfully to the door. And you stand, observe standing, then you move your hands. You touch and you push mindfully. And you have to put down your hands, then walk outside. Mindfully observe your step. Standing. Sitting down. Then you see the food, seeing. When you are desire, no desire. Then move your hand, touch. Take the food, move your hand for the food. Then chewing, swallowing. When you are chewing, swallowing, do not move your hands. So after you completely finish chewing, swallowing, you take another food. Then put down. And chewing, swallowing. So when you do eating, so you cannot observe everything, but you have to observe as much as you can. So you are taking the food, so you are opening the mouth, putting the food into the mouth, chewing. Especially when the food is this very good, you want to do very swallow very quickly, you have to observe. Trying to observe as much as you can. Do not try to be very quick. In this way, practicing eating, you can gain a lot of mindfulness.